Today, we have an incredible topic to discuss that has been making headlines recently. China's ambitious South-North Water Transfer Project. Did you know that China is spending a staggering $90 billion on this massive undertaking? Stick around as we delve into the details of this groundbreaking project and its potential implications. Let's get started. The South-North Water Transfer Project, often referred to as SNWTP, is one of the most significant infrastructure initiatives in China's history. It aims to address the country's severe water scarcity issues by diverting water from the water-rich south to the water-scarce north. This colossal undertaking involves a series of canals, tunnels, and pipelines spanning thousands of kilometers. The SNWTP was initially proposed in the 1950s, but gained momentum in the early 2000s when the Chinese government realized the urgent need to combat water scarcity. The project consists of three main routes: the eastern, central, and western routes, each serving different regions of China. The eastern route draws water from the Yangtze River, while the central and western routes source their water from the Danjiangku Reservoir. The eastern route, the first to be completed in 2013, spans over 1,400 kilometers, connecting the Yangtze River with cities such as Tianjin and Beijing. It has been instrumental in addressing the water needs of densely populated areas in the north. The central route, which began operations in 2014, involves redirecting water from the Danjiangku Reservoir in central China to arid regions like Henan and Hebei provinces. It spans over 1,260 kilometers and has significantly alleviated water scarcity in these areas. The western route, the most challenging and expensive part of the project, is still under construction. It aims to supply water to the arid northwest regions of China, including Xinjiang and Gansu provinces. This route will divert water from the upper reaches of the Yangtze River and is expected to be completed in the coming years. The primary objective of the SNWTP is to mitigate water scarcity in the north, where water resources are limited. By diverting water from the water-rich south to the north, China aims to ensure a stable water supply for its growing population and industrial activities. Improved water availability from the SNWTP is expected to spur socioeconomic development in the northern regions. It will support agriculture, industry, and urbanization, providing a boost to local economies and improving the quality of life for millions of people. However, the project also poses environmental challenges. The diversion of water from one region to another can disrupt local ecosystems and impact the natural flow of rivers. It's essential for China to carefully manage the environmental consequences and implement sustainable practices during the project's execution. Like any large-scale project, the South-North Water Transfer Project faces its fair share of challenges and criticisms. One of the main criticisms revolves around the enormous cost of the project. With an estimated budget of $90 billion, some argue that the funds could be better utilized in developing alternative water sources or implementing more sustainable solutions. The SNWTP involves the resettlement of numerous communities along the canal routes, causing disruptions and displacement for the affected populations. Critics argue that the project's benefits may not outweigh the social costs incurred by the people who are uprooted from their homes and ancestral lands. Environmentalists express concerns about the ecological impacts of diverting water from one region to another. The project can disrupt river ecosystems, affect aquatic habitats, and alter natural flow patterns, potentially leading to unintended consequences for both wildlife and local communities that depend on these ecosystems. Another challenge is the potential deterioration of water quality during the transfer process. The canals and reservoirs used in the SNWTP could become breeding grounds for pollutants, leading to contamination and the need for extensive water treatment measures. As mentioned earlier, the eastern and central routes are already operational and have significantly alleviated water scarcity in the target regions. The western route, though still under construction, holds immense promise for the arid northwest areas of China. The SNWTP has the potential to unlock economic opportunities and support urban development in the northern regions. Reliable water supply can attract investments, improve agricultural productivity, and enhance overall living conditions for the local population. Looking ahead, the successful completion and management of the SNWTP will require continuous monitoring and adaptation. climate change, evolving water demands, and shifting socioeconomic factors necessitate a flexible and resilient approach to ensure the long-term sustainability of the project. The South North Water Transfer Project serves as an example of China's commitment to addressing its water scarcity challenges. It also offers valuable insights and lessons for other countries facing similar issues, showcasing the potential of large-scale water transfer projects when executed with careful planning, environmental considerations, and social welfare in mind. The South North Water Transfer Project not only has domestic significance, but also carries important international implications. Water scarcity is a critical issue in many regions globally, and the SNWTP sets an example of how countries can tackle such challenges. By addressing water security within its borders, China aims to ensure stability and reduce the potential for conflicts related to water resources with neighboring countries. The SNWTP involves diverting water from major rivers such as the Yangtze, which also flow into neighboring countries like Vietnam and Myanmar. The project's impact on downstream regions and the potential for disputes over water allocation and ecological changes remain subjects of concern and require open communication and cooperation between nations. China's massive investment in the South North Water Transfer Project showcases its technological prowess and ability to undertake ambitious infrastructure projects. It serves as a symbol of the country's economic and technical capabilities, bolstering its image on the global stage and potentially opening doors for diplomatic engagements and collaborations with other nations. The SNWTP highlights the importance of integrated water management strategies that take into account the diverse needs of various sectors, including agriculture, industry, and domestic consumption. It underscores the significance of balancing water supply and demand, implementing efficient water use practices, and exploring alternative water sources. The scale and complexity of the SNWTP necessitate technological innovation in areas such as water transfer, conservation, and treatment. The project encourages the development of advanced technologies and engineering solutions that can be applied to similar water management projects globally, fostering a culture of innovation and collaboration. The South North Water Transfer Project aligns with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, particularly Goal 6, which aims to ensure the availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. It serves as an example of how countries can work toward achieving these global goals by implementing large-scale water management projects. The South North Water Transfer Project stands as a testament to China's determination to tackle water scarcity and its commitment to sustainable development. While the project faces challenges and criticisms, it also offers valuable lessons and inspiration for the future. By considering environmental impacts, social welfare, and international cooperation, countries can learn from this groundbreaking initiative and work towards securing water resources for a more sustainable and prosperous future. Thank you for joining us today, and remember to stay tuned for more engaging discussions.